Now let's talk about ABBYY FlexiCapture system architecture. We'll touch on workstation components, server components. We'll touch on fault tolerance and cluster support, as well as local versus distributed FlexiCapture installations. FlexiCapture standalone installs on a single machine and is designed for lower volume installation use cases, up to 50,000 pages per month suggested. The bottleneck is verification. Only one person can verify. Multiple people could actually scan to hot folders. So we could have a lot of scanning going on, but only one verification operator working at a time. So if you don't have a lot of verification going on, then you could certainly exceed 50,000 pages per month. FlexiCapture Distributed allows multiple users to work concurrently. We see several data verification station operators, and scanning station operators. So this is a very scalable system designed for large projects and enterprises. We can drill down and look in more detail about ABBYY FlexiCapture Distributed Components. This diagram was taken from the Administrator's Guide and shows components, workstations, and server components. We'll drill down in more detail in subsequent slides. First off, we have the FlexiCapture application server, and it is at the heart and soul of a FlexiCapture distributed installation. Then we'll have a database as well as a file storage location. Talk more about those. We'll have a processing server, which is a load balancer, as well as a licensing server, which keeps tabs of how many pages are processed and how many workstation licenses are in use. We have processing stations. They do OCR tasks as well as ingestion tasks and export tasks. We have verification stations, data verification stations, and scanning stations, thick client, as well as web-based. And we've got the project setup station, which we'll be using a lot in the upcoming PowerPoints. We'll be focused on a lot. Flexi Layout Studio as well. And Form Designer is used to design forms to capture handwriting. Lastly, we have the administration and monitoring console. The application server and DB server are components that work very closely together. The DB server actually holds information about operators, batches, task status, all sorts of good information that you can do reporting off of. And that database doesn't need to be SQL Server. We also support these other databases as well. The administration monitoring console allows users to access a dashboard, and this is the URL. You can do a lot of different tasks with the administration monitoring console, reporting, security, cleanup, quite a bit of things you can do there. File storage. When you're installing FlexiCapture Distributed, you have the option of where you can specify where you want to place the documents that are ingested into the system. The best recommendation is to put those images into a folder on the application server. It doesn't need to be that big usually because FlexiCapture is not a repository. So this is short-term storage. You can also do network attached storage. If you store the images in the database, it's an option, but it's going to slow your system down. The license server has a GUI installed. Really, anyone can install FlexiCapture, but in order for FlexiCapture to operate, it has to have an active license. So you bring up the license server GUI, and you copy the serial number, and you activate this license to get going. The serial number can also be burned onto a USB dongle. There's also a processing server, which is a load balancer. It comes with a GUI so that you can keep track of processing stations. So here we've got a processing server. It's up and running, green arrow. And we've got one processing station that's up and running, two that are paused. And if we want to, we can also look specifically at background tasks. And if we double click on one of these tasks, we get a lot of detailed information about what's going on in the system. And we can view and export that log. The project setup station is typically for administrators who want to set up document definitions to process. A project could contain batch types, which are, I want to call them projects within a project. They're sub-projects. We'll talk more about those later. Image import profiles are set up here as well. Those are things like hot folders. At the document definition level, we set up document exports, and we can also set up different workflow settings. The processing station, as I mentioned earlier, has three main tasks. One is loading images from hot folders, that's ingestion. The next task is applying document definitions and performing OCR, recognizing the data on the documents. And lastly, exporting of data is done from the processing station. So these are CPU intensive tasks, and very typically processing stations are virtualized, and very typically their CPUs are pegged. The scan station allows you to scan large amounts of document using a GUI. The data verification station is set up for people who are very fast at data entry, typically, and they can adjudicate low confidence characters. They can resolve some rule violations. Here there's a format error. The date was in the wrong format. But when it comes to complex verification, that's usually done in the verification station. So oftentimes it's a two-pass endeavor, a bifurcated effort where data verification happens first. All the low confidence characters are knocked out. As you can see here, we've got 100% confidence level, meaning there's no low confidence characters. And there may be some rule violations left for a verification station operator. You can not use data verification station and perform all of those same steps in the verification station as well. And we've got web stations. So you can either use the thick client, scan station, verification station, or the thin client. And in the administrator's guide, we discuss various disaster recovery strategies. And we've got some other resources that discuss these different approaches to disaster recovery. FlexiCapture Distributed has a very robust web service API. And with it, we can initiate batches, send images to FlexiCapture, start processing, get the results back. You can control processes using web service API calls. So you can create your own application and use ABBYY FlexiCapture as a service in the background. So FlexiCapture provides automated conversion of various forms and documents of any structure or complexity, fixed forms, semi-structured, unstructured forms. We have a scalable architecture that allows you to select necessary system configurations, making adjustments as needed. So when we talked about processing stations, how they're doing the heavy lifting, the OCR, the CPU-intensive tasks of OCR and export, you can scale that by adding more processing stations. That would be horizontally scaling your system. Or you could add more CPUs. Very typically, processing stations are virtualized, so we can add more CPUs to a given processing station and thus vertically scale. So we've got a variety of schemes for scaling. And our client-server architecture ensures fast and effective document processing and data capture.